क्लास 8 वी विल कंटिन्यू आवर चैप्टर नंबर 1 ऑपरेटिंग सिस्टम. टुडे आई विल एक्सप्लेन यू द फंक्शंस ऑफ ऑपरेटिंग सिस्टम, एडवांटेज एंड डिसएडवांटेजेस ऑफ ऑपरेटिंग सिस्टम्स एंड कंपोनेंट्स ऑफ डेस्कटॉप. नाउ we will continue our chapter operating system computer applications class 8 operating system, in short form it is known as OS. In an operating system, software performs each of the functions. Means I am explaining the functions of an operating system. First is process management. Process management helps operating system to create and delete processes. It also provides mechanism for synchronization and communications among processes. It means it will communicate between users and systems. We can say that it process between the users and the hardwares. Second, memory management. Memory management module performs the task of allocation and deallocation of memory space to programs in need of these resources. It means it management the memory of the computer and it performs the task how to allocate and disallocate the spaces according to the programs. Third, file management. It manages all the file related activities such as organization, storage, retrieval, naming, sharing and protection of files. Means it manages the files of the computers and it gives the space according to their size of files to the in the computer system. Device management. Device management keeps track of all devices like all hardware devices, means input devices, output devices and storage devices. This module also responsible for this task known as IO. IO means input output controller. It also performs the task of allocation and deallocation of the devices. Now, IO system management means input output system management. In this, it manages the input and output of the input and output system of the computer, and it manages the space of input and output. One of the main objects of any operating system is to hide the peculiarities of that hardware devices from the user. Secondary storage management means the devices for which we are using for storage outside from the system. Systems have several levels of storage, which includes primary storage and secondary storage. Primary storage are inbuilt in the system, and secondary storage we are using outside from the system, and cache storage it is also including in the system. Instructions and data must be stored in primary storage or cache so that a running program can reference it. Security module protects the data and information of a computer system against malware threats and authorized access. Malware threats means they are related to the viruses, and the persons which have made the program to break the security of the computer. So this operating system also manages the security of the system. Command interpretations. This module is interpreting commands given by the end acting system resources to process that commands. Means it interpret the command between the user and the computer system. Networking. A distributed system is a group of processors which do not share memory, hardware devices, or a clock. The processors communicate with one another through the network. Means, when we suppose we have closed the computer, we know that a computer also have a clock which show the time. If we have closed the computer, we have off the computer. After that, some time we will open that. Then we will see the current time in the system. This will manage by the networking of the system. Job accounting, keeping track of time and resource used by various job and users. Communication management, coordination and assignment of compilers, interpreter and another software resource of the various users of the computer system. Communication means, you know that compilers and interpreter are used to convert the high level language into machine level language or machine level language into high level language. So this will manage by the operating system. Now, what is the advantages of using operating system? Some advantages are here. First is it allows which software or hardware will work. You to hide details of hardware by creating an abstractions. Easy to use with a GUI, graphic user interface. It will help to use the GUI. Offers an environment in which a user may execute programs, applications. It gives the environment where the user execute the programs or the applications. The operating system must make sure that the computer system convenient to use. Means operating systems helps to computer system to use easily. Operating system acts as intermediary among applications and the hardware components. Means it is the mediator between the application and the hardware components. It provides the computer system resources with easy to use format. It acts as an intermediator between all hardwares and softwares of the system. These are the advantages of the operating system. Now, disadvantages of using operating system. There are some disadvantages also, which are, if any issue occurs in operating system, you may lose all the content which have been stored in your system. This is the disadvantage. If operating system has any error, any type of issue, then it will be lose our data which we have stored in our system. Second, operating system software is quite expensive for small size organization, which adds burden on them. For example, Windows. If we will buy Windows from an authorized organization, it will be very costly, very, very expensive. So that it is a burden for a small size organization. It is never entirely secure, as a threat can occur at any time. Mean it will never give the security for threats or any viruses. Now, Windows 8. Windows 8 is an operating system that has produced by Microsoft. Released as part of Windows NT family of, NT means networking, family of operating systems. The product was released to manufacturing on August 1st, 2012. Means Windows 8 manufactured in 1st August 2012. And generally to retail on October 26, 2012. Now it will be retailing after 1.5 months. It is the successor of Windows 7. Best feature of Windows operating system is speed. Its speed is so high, compatibility, lower hardware requirements, search and organization, safety and security, interface and desktop, taskbar and start menu. These are the best features of Windows. Now, desktop icons represent files, directories, application functions and removable media like CDs or DVDs. You know which is the what is the desktop? Desktop is the screen. When we will start our computer system, a screen will come by default. That screen is known as the desktop. Desktop has the following icon by default. First is trash. Trash is also known as the recycle bin. It contains files and folders that have been deleted. For information about using the trash, can see FCHIP 1.3.4, Managing the Trash Bin. It is also known as the recycle bin. My computer. It displays information about hardware, network status, operating system, hard disk, common folders and removable devices. For more information after of FCHIP 1.33, Assessing Removable Media. Network Browsing. Displays network services you can access. Some of the services might require authentication. To learn more, refer to Capital 8, Assessing Network Resources. Chrome is also there. Main menu icon. By default, the left end of the panel has an icon that opens the main menu. That is KDE, also called K menu. Similar to the start button on the MS Windows desktop. The main menu has a well-ordered structure for accessing the main application. It also contains menu items for major functions like logging out or searching for applications. For more information, see FCHIP 1.3.1, accessing the main menu. Next is Quick Launcher. Next to the main menu icon, find the Quick Launcher. It holds some icons for the most important functions or applications to enable you to start them without going through the main menu. Suppose we want to start any, and the Quick Launcher have to open that icon and open that software. Desktop Reviewer. Next to the Quick Launcher, find the Desktop Reviewer, which shows your different desktop. These virtual desktops enable you to organize your work. If you use many programs simultaneously, you might want to run some programs in one desktop and other program in the other desktop. To switch between desktop, click the desktop symbol in the panel. Taskbar. Taskbar is located next to the desktop reviewer. By default, all started applications and open windows are displayed in the taskbar, which allows you to access any application regardless of the currently active desktop. If you click a window title in the taskbar, the application is moved to the foreground, means it will come on the screen. If it is already in the foreground, clicking minimize the application. You can minimize that application, you can close that application, and you can maximize the application by the buttons which are giving on right top corner. Now, system tray. The rightmost part of the panel usually holds the system clock, the volume control, and several other helper applications. These are the components of a desktop. In my next video, I will explain you the next chapter. So, you will prepare this chapter and you will revise this chapter. And you will read this chapter from your book also. And you will try to do that assignment which I have given and submit that assignment on time. Hope you all understood this chapter. If you have any problem, you can contact me through email. Thank you.